buddy. What do you think about my flyers? Things are pretty sweet, ain't they? Why don't you be taking them? There we go. We got some people coming, baby. Woo! What's up, guys? Welcome to another live here on Gentry & Sons Trucking. It is super nice to have y'all back. We're going to get started. We just blew a tire under a load, and this thing's got to go. So we got to get the tire changed. We got some other stuff to talk about. We got a lot to do tonight. I was going to upload you guys a video, but I ain't got time to edit the video. So, working on it though. I think we did hire a new editor today. It seems like it. What's up, everybody? Getting some people in here. We're at 300 already.
Yeah.
Huh.
We're gonna get all the burnout vehicles on again.
Hmm? We're gonna
get all the burnout vehicles on again.
Yeah, I know.
All broken.
All right, I got the 359 done. Pretty much done. You grab a booster, I'll get it. We're going to try to keep this live interesting and fun and moving forward. Everything keeps messing up on me this week. Hey, this thing's sweet now. Ready to flip that on? Big cam. Well, I think it does sound pretty good. The house truck's doing pretty good. And flew to the mouth. Daggone. Guys, I'm back. It's 87. Brand new. Got a new motor, new turbo, new air compressor, new AC. Just redid all the wiring on it. It's a big cam. Big cam smoke like that when it's cold. And literally, I mean, I literally just fired it today and started moving it. We got to take it down the road and get her good and hot. Whoa! Are you going over the trailer or are you just pulling up to it? You had to back up and get way over. Well, that is a beautiful truck. All right, cut it that way. Go that way. Cut it this way, son. Brax must have forgot how to drive tonight. Yeah, it's got a 400 big cam in it. I don't know. Turn your headlights on, Brax. There you go. Yeah, the windshield's dirty. Beside the trailer, son. Put it beside it, not behind it. See, it's starting to clear up now that it's warming up. It's a pretty nice old truck. It needs some work. Needs some TLC. That's good, Brax. All right, we gotta get to business. All right, that's what we're dealing with tonight. We're going to fire something up and build up some air. We got us a blowed tar. This thing's got new rubber on it. Why it blowed, but it did. Luckily, it didn't get airbag. Nope, they're not recaps, they're virgins. I need to get the camera guy. Dang, we're at 1,000 people already. Brax, you're on the camera.
I see. It was far up.
Was it?
Yeah, things. That's the only thing I don't like about 359 is you don't have a lot of leg room. But, all right, I'm going to try to back this thing in here.
What's wrong with it?
Blow a tire.
Oh. Yeah. I'm gonna buff this thing again. Starting to get faded.
Pigtail.
Yeah.
Keep killing the lights around town.
Yeah. Where'd that blow out at?
Thank you. Yeah, Braxton blew the tire.
Yep. Where'd it blow it?
I don't know. She just come in with a blow tour. All right. Actually, I need to back it on up. Sounds muffled. I gotta jack it up first, Briggs. All right, we're getting some good reports of sound. Yeah, we gotta fix pigtail, I guess. Yeah. What bag? Dad's on the road with that boat.
grab my pliers too. Loaded heavy.
What's loaded?
Yeah.
What's in it, Steven?
No message. Thank you.
You're out front end, Brax.
Is this which way it goes?
I don't know, I'll just have to mash it and see. Nope.
Is that the right one?
You know which way to go. There you go. My luck, it is. It's gonna be serious. Well, time. Thank you.
huh? Now the work starts.
Wire I haven't put on to run the APU while the engine's running. It's wired up wrong. It thinks the engine's running at the truck, so it shuts the APU on.
Oh, yeah. You didn't bring it yet.
Yeah. I didn't either until I got to looking at the screen and it says main engine running, APU turn off.
Okay.
I went, because they do tell themselves to keep it running while the engine's running. The wire has to go on a specific post of the alternator.
Oh, yeah.
So he's going to look into that this morning. And when y'all put my AC compressor back on or whatever, I've got no power to it.
I'll pull it in. When I get done with this, I'll just pull it in.
Okay. It's a dirty mess because I let down mud and shit up there.
Yeah. I'll pull it in. Mess here.
Well, if I don't hear from you by 9:30 or so, I'll come up here and be ready to go. Okay. And I said, when did Jason break down?
Blew the tire.
I blew the damn tire.
Yes.
You probably didn't know.
That harness goes from the AC to the alternator. I know exactly what. I'll fix it.
I know what it is.
All right, well, I will see y'all tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, I was planning on delivering. I was grabbing you a medical load this weekend.
Medical?
Yeah.
That'll work.
We're starting that new deal, so.
Oh, but all's good with it?
Yeah.
You running live or recording?
Live.
Ah. Howdy, y'all.
Right.
Good deal. All right, buddy. I'll see y'all tomorrow.
All right, guys, we're back. I think we're at like 1,400 people. Sorry, guys. Usually I like to talk in the live, but we're trying to keep some action going. I think we're at 47 minutes. We're slacking, Brax, on one tire.
How long is the
There you go, little man.
I seen a whole bunch of them in there the other day.
I
All right, guys, so this is a lot of time. You still have to change them without doing this. But the most important thing, because usually what leaks is valve stems. You got drivers checking tires all the time, you hope, anyway. And then we always check them before they go out. So they're always getting checked and air pressure gauges hooked to them. So a lot of times they'll go bad. So put your new valve stem in. They're cheap. It's cheap maintenance. And it's a lot cheaper than putting a new tire on the side of the road, too. A lot cheaper. Because you didn't have a good valve stem. Braxton's not who the first person who ever made a wrench was. Anybody answer that?
John Ham Peter. Dang, you're old.
No.
1630s.
It's first one. All right, guys. The first thing I should have done is check this rim for cracks. It's always good to check for cracks. We get the, where's the tire? Yeah, the tire, correct? No, we won't target. Alright, so it's always good to check for cracks. Make sure where your valve stem goes sealed. Good position right in the middle. This one looks good. Then I always where it seals and goes down the boom. I know this looks like, you know, a lot of guys will just take the tire off, put one back on, and I've done that many, many times. But if you don't do this and one don't seal, and you got a leak and you don't catch a crack, then you got another hour's labor involved in it. Or you can go ahead and do it now, and that looks good.
You see how that car crashed? Or a race car or something like that?
Tape on the bar.
valve for you. Oh, you know the drill. Guys, it's usually better to do it with the bead blaster, but not on these 11 R's. These 11 R's, you'll fight them all night long. Come on, guys, 1,000 likes and we're blowing this tire up, baby. I got the valve core out of it. Oh, Lord. Guys, don't do this at home. Only do it, this is done by a trained professional, whatever you call it. It's not something you should do at home, though, I'm just telling you. Just like that.
She's on there. Oh, thanks, guys. I'm running my flashlight dead. I know, guys, that is not the correct way to do it, but... it works for me. And you fight these 11R22 fives, that is the best way to do it. Might not be the correct way, but it is the best way. Do what? Where's the gauge at? Checker. Where's the good air chug at? That thing is annoying. Yeah.
Is that dump truck up there?
My dump truck? Yeah, I got the Mac up there. Yeah, 100. Oh man, I bet you didn't bring my new air gauge today. I got a new one, guys, from Matco that makes it a lot safer airing these tires up. Hey, we have 1,500 people in live tonight. Heck yeah. We've got a cheetah, but that cheetah ain't gonna, they suck on these 22, these tall 22s. 90 likes away from 1,000. We need to start blowing tires up more often, Brax. Yeah, boys. All right, if you want one of these cool shirts that Brax has got on, you just gotta go to gentryandsonstrucking.com and you get your very own. 80. Here, you want to hold the phone, let me air it up. That way if it blows up, it'll take Daddy out, not you.
I
need you to live a little longer than me.
Get a air bunch up for the S10. We're going to blow out on that when it drives again.
You know what's crazy? Guys, I have a whole entire shop of tools. And that I buy. And it's crazy. Everybody else's toolbox has got all these great tools in them. And then all mine are gone. But I think that's every shop. Every shop I've ever been to is like that. Even like professional big shops. Get me one of them tire cages
because
we have had two tires blow up
once. I know that dump truck's fine. It got a little loud.
Yeah, that thing's on the inside.
Yeah. potato guy. Shoot potatoes at stuff. Did you get Rooster done?
Yep. Rooster's back and alive. I used it today. Used him today. £100 on the dot, baby.
There was one in the floor, I think.
In the floor?
At least you picked it up.
I'll go back here and get a new one.
Figure out which one on the white truck? Figure out which one on the white truck yet?
Nope, I'm gonna do it.
So it's just like, there's no power.
We're on night shift tonight, Rex.
You just lose power?
Yeah, I don't know if it blew it. It blew a, it may have blew a, I don't know if it blew gear, if it blew an injector, I don't know what it done. There's something wrong with it.
Oh. Can you just put bull gear or something in this one?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah. Shouldn't be the bull gear.
Need a weld one.
Guys put them up under a trailer and aired them up, and actually picked the trailer up and get stuck under it, like an empty trailer. We'll do that. This is something loaded down.
Fool.
I got one of them new fancy tire tools. I put it up on the truck.
Yeah.
I ain't got enough room to cross the street.
Yeah. I need that turbo off the skid steer. You want to put a bigger one on it one day?
You want my turbo or the skid steer?
Yeah, it's small.
How am I going to use the skid steer if you're taking the turbo?
I'll put a big old 80 millimeter on it.
On the skid steer?
Yeah.
Why don't you just put 80 millimeter on whatever you want to take it off and put it on?
I don't know, a good fuller. Look good. Need some notches.
First one.
I'm gonna go ahead and change one in the parking lot. On Rooster. Boat trailer.
So Dad is going on that boat haul, guys, to finish it up. I'm not gonna lie, I am really enjoying some shop time. Like it feels pretty good to be in the shop. Alright, you want the valve stem to be across from each other. Instead of, you don't want even because you can't put that in.
Car sounds pretty good.
Next?
Yeah.
I quit, Jimmy. Huh?
I quit.
You quit?
Yep.
quitting on me?
No, I'm quitting on me.
Oh.
I go to start the car up.
What happened?
Freaking. With the trailer sitting here?
Yeah.
Like, I must have a little leak in the trailer?
No.
It put probably a gallon of freaking water down the freaking exhaust.
No.
I started the car up, I went, whoa, 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 and it shoved probably a gallon of water up the freaking turbo.
Dang.
But, I thought it vented out or something like that, so I pulled the injectors out, because I wasn't sure if it was water or injectors. Pulled all the injectors out, flow tested them.
None of them leaked. I was like, okay, like, that's not it. And then, yeah, so now I'm freaking troubleshooting it. Took all the valve train apart, and it rolls over fine with the valve train apart, but like with the valve train on it, like it's tight.
Is it missing?
Like it wouldn't start. Oh. It wouldn't turn over.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Dude, it was raining pretty good earlier, but it was coming off the back of the trailer.
Yeah, we filled up a 5 gallon bucket twice.
Dang.
Well, I think there's a seam.
Yeah.
And the screwed up part about it is normally the truck is like a foot farther back on the lift. Well, I didn't have it strapped down in there, right? So, like, it was farther forward.
Man.
Lined up right with the seam, and I think it was just dripping down that seam with all the water that was coming off the roof onto the friggin' onto the trailer.
Me and Nick's got about the same luck. Like, literally. I don't even want to start my car. It's probably full of water, too. Even though it's in a dry trailer.
Dude, when I started this thing up, I'm telling you, like, probably half a gallon of water shot out the turbo. It went, rum, rum, rum. And it's just like, whoa.
Oh, man. I bet you was sick. Do you think it was methanol?
I wasn't sure what it was. I was hoping it was kind of methanol, but like, I don't know.
I think it sucks.
But yeah, I tried to turn the motor over after that, and I was like, oh, no. So I don't know. Go through and check it all out.
Well, it looks like the live's going to get real good tonight, boys.
You're working on twin turbo big block.
Had to throw LS in.
Get you the race this weekend.
I am calling quits on Texas. I still want to go there. I feel like we got a good car over there.
Did I feel like this?
That Kentucky race seems decent.
Yeah, it is.
Friggin' London.
Oh, dude. I want to
go. The only problem is, like,
I want to go to London bad.
They're advertising at $20,000 at 64 cars, but, like, what is it at 32 cars? Is it still 10 grand?
Yeah, I bet. Last year, they was. I'm talking a heck of a car count.
Really?
Yeah.
How fast do you think it's going to be to win it?
Probably 550s. 560s. I think you'd have a really good shot up there.
Absolutely.
And it sucks for me, but, you know.
Are you going?
I was planning on it. Not now.
What day is that, Saturday?
I'll go watch you.
You can be my merch guy.
Yeah. Yeah, I was coming to Kentucky this weekend. I'll save some merch. I won't be racing.
How far away is
no,
it?
No, I might just run the street class, though, if you want to run small tire.
What is it, a couple hours away?
Hour and a half.
I can get it fixed by then.
Yeah. No, London would be a good race. Be a good race to go test the car, too, really get to test it.
I was legit just, like, setting the time. I started up to set the time and verify the timing and stuff like that because I had the cam sync and everything out of it.
Man, that sucks.
I was like, oh.
I wish I could get the Pro Charger on mine before then go test it, but
that'd be a lot.
That's a lot of work. But, I mean, it would probably do good up there on small tire or street class.
I don't think so.
I think I could probably go win it if I get somebody racing in the finals. You're Taylor driving the finals.
I really wanted to make it to Texas. Damn it.
I just feel like there's something saying you don't need to go to that. It's been a lot of different things.
I'm a couple years older now, and I think I have more wisdom, and I think I agree with you.
Yeah, there's
like, there's something to be said with pushing through with the struggles, right?
Yeah.
But there's also a point where, like...
There's got to be a reason why.
There's a higher up, or there's some type of reason that you're having these delays.
Yep.
And, like, the way, like, I'll say it this way, but my health issues and stuff like that... I can't jump in the truck and have to be there in 12 hours. He's like,
yeah,
my 12-hour trip might turn into a 24-hour trip. Like,
No, I agree with that 100%. I would like to go to Texas with you,
though.
But
see, like, even when I went and got Bruce yesterday, I thought, well, I'll just have Nick take Bruce.
Mm-hmm.
And the radiator's leaking. Mm-hmm. So there's something.
Yeah, because we were going to jump in Brutus. Maddie and the baby were going to fly in. Or they were planning on flying, and I already bought the tickets and stuff like that. And then we had some important medical stuff to go on friggin' Tuesday after the race.
Yeah, so she has and to fly just, back home. That's what I'm saying.
I just feel like there's something.
There's too many things going on.
And then maybe we go to London and went up there and then to really test the car.
Texas is going to be a tough competition, isn't it?
Yeah. I feel like it's one of those bucket list races. I've wanted to go out there for about 3 years now.
Oh, it's yellow wheel, yeah.
Yellow wheel.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Dang, I'd like to go there.
It's going to be probably the biggest.
I wonder if Jimmy Dale will be there.
He's the one hosting the race.
Oh, I definitely want to go to that race. All right. We need to get Bonnie hooked up.
Get Bonnie hooked up to the trailer. I'll work in the stacker as you drive. I got eight rods in the freaking trailer if need be.
Torque wrench owners, you good to go, boys.
Woo!
That'll get you going in the evenings. All right, let's go check out the next ride, see what's going on with it. Man, that sucks. We just got that thing back together. Yeah. That's one of the other reasons why we were thinking about not going to Texas is because the thing that happened with Callie and Nate and all that, it's really making us rethink things. And my car is about to be 10 times faster than it is now. So I want to do a little bit more safety stuff to it. Man, that sucks.
I ain't completely dead in the water yet, but I'm also curious because I put all the time certs in. Now the...
Did they torque good?
They torqued fine, but the push rods are really close to the freaking deal. So I'm wondering when they're all set and stuff like that, the push rods are starting to bind up on the freaking guide plates. So
I have a torque wrench for tires, guys. I'll go torque it in a minute.
I might have to go redo the freaking, take your guide plates out and redo it.
Yep. Yeah, Callie and Nate wrecked in the Z unit. And we're all kind of bummed about that.
Yeah, it's kind of. That kind of. I think that hurts everyone's spirits a little bit.
It does.
There's the realization of we all know what we're doing. And I'm not saying we're numb to that realization because, like, I've had my fair share of incidents. You have had your fair share of incidents. Anyone that's.
We've all been lucky to survive the wrecks we've had.
Yeah, almost
I guess most adult males have been in that situation before, right?
Yeah.
But like a situation like that, when it hits close to home, it just gives you that, it just hits close to home.
Yeah, it does.
Makes you rethink things a little bit.
And guys, this right here is a bad little girl right here. It's twin turbo, big block, like 2,000 horsepower plus. And I mean, this car fits Nick really good though. Like he's in the cage. He's already wrecked one with his cage in it and he survived it. You know, it was a rollover. It was kind of like Kelly and H wreck. Nick went rolling in the other car, but I mean, we've all wrecked. It's just, you know, Kelly Nate's been in a lot of wrecks, though. Like, I mean, that dude, he's a legit, man. He was legit.
I make way more passes than the average racer. Kelly Nate probably makes twice the amount of passes that I make.
Oh, yeah. He's, and he's an
up. Maybe more. We race a lot. We make a lot of passes, but he probably 2 to 3 times more passes he made, like, a year than I did. I bet you he'd make 400 passes a year. 300-400 passes a year.
This guy said Tim just thinks he's Cletus. Cletus does a total different kind of racing than we do. Mm-hmm. Total different racing.
Z unit was a bad unit. I first saw that car. It had the Whipple supercharger on it with some nitrous on it. And that was back in the, at the time it was 2019, Kansas City's largest cash days. And we had the Dirty 30 out there. He had Z unit. Beater Bomb was out there. Kendall Goyne was out there. I mean, there were some of the best cars, one of the best cars in the country out there. I'm not saying we were we fit in there, but we were out there and we won a couple rounds. But yeah, that was Kendall Goyne won that one. But that was back when Toby, he passed away several years ago now. But it was unbelievable. How he had that Kansas City region safe and locked down with security and stuff like that. And it was all extracurricular activities on the street. But, that place was safe. Security within, zones of security. So,
yeah.
there was no possible way that you're going to be racing with cars coming in, anywhere in the region. So, there are good roads out there and safe roads. Pretty cool deal. But Nate was a bad dude. He lost first round, I think. Somehow, some way in the Z unit. I think one of the guys out of Kansas City beat him.
Dude, that Z unit car is bad to the bone.
I know, bad. You should have seen the one that had the friggin' Whipple supercharger on it. The Whipple friggin' nitrous. That thing was rowdy. Why is that rowdy? That was friggin' wicked.
I couldn't imagine crawling in the car. I don't know. This thing here, I don't know. It fits Nick really good, but I'm too big for this thing. And if I was to get into wrecking to this thing, it'd probably throw me around and I'd be hitting bars.
If I was building it for you, I'd build it differently. When I build a car, I build it for me. So I feel as safe in it as I can be.
He said, "Hey, Tim, why won't you call FSC or SRC boys if your car is so fast?" I mean, I ain't saying it's so fat. I mean, it runs good. Car runs all right.
We can run up there and we could go run them.
Yeah.
Straight gangster is on the feet against the best.
Yeah, I mean, we got...
They got more wins against me than I got against them, but they haven't beat Straight Gangster yet.
I'd like to race the old man with the Mustang, and then
that'd be cool race.
You go race the S10 or the...
You and the...
I think me and the old man would be a good race.
You and the Marlboro. Pretty similar type cars.
Yep, we're both pretty much street cars, so. I don't know, guys. We love this racing stuff, and most trucking companies have a race team or have race cars or.
It's a similar affiliation.
It is. We like to drive stuff. We like to work on stuff. You got a shop. You got stuff to haul your race cars with. Why not race? But, I mean, I'd love to be like Cletus, honestly. I mean, that's part of being an influencer. You influence people to be better.
Cletus is... What he's done down there is just simply amazing.
Oh, it is.
I want to say it was 2014, 2015 I first met him when he was working with 1320 Video. And the first time I met him, you could tell he had a knack about him that had, like,
yeah,
just there was potential there.
Dude, he's got, he hustles. Like, that is the most hustling. I mean, like, when we went to Vegas, the first time I ever hauled the cars out to Vegas, we literally got there, spent all night working on the cars, raced all day the next day, blew the cars up, and then stayed up all night again just to make a pass the next day, changing motors out. I mean, and it's been like that at, like, every event we go to, like, always changing motors. So Cletus has got to hustle. James hustles. Like, all them guys hustle, and everybody's a big team. And that's what I like about them guys.
A team down there.
Yeah.
That's the ideal situation where you have a real team behind you that, you know, when one person's being a little slower, this or that, other people pick up the slack.
Yep.
They got a great setup down there.
So, like, I got one of Cletus' old motors coming. James is bringing it down next week. And for the one of my Mustangs, and like, they're this that good. Like, James called me the other day. He's like, "Hey, I about got your motor built. I'll be there with it next week." And them guys are good for you. Do good for them. They do good for you. Same thing with Nick. And like,
one man watches the other.
That's what I like about the racing community.
It's usually pretty good.
Yeah, that jukebox guy, you're right. I mean, that Mustang is my release. Like, Nick got to see it firsthand the other day. For all the stress I go through here and the work and stuff, and then we went racing, and I just had the best time. I mean, like,
that was fun.
Laughing and smiling and clapping and screaming and yelling. Like, I just had the best time. You make a pass and you win a race, it is just the best feeling ever. It's unexplainable. What is that, Brax?
It doesn't last long enough, but it is fun.
No, the adrenaline is just like, God, it's such a good feeling.
I don't do drugs or nothing like that, but I don't know. It almost feels like, what is that? Like heroin or something like that, where it lasts like 3 seconds. Then
yeah, you're just like, poof.
And then you work your butt off all week long.
Just to make a pass.
For another 5 seconds of enjoyment, 4 seconds of enjoyment.
Man, that sucks. You got your valve covers back off. This thing was ready to go. God, that sucks.
It was ready to go. Not no more.
Literally, like, see that street there?
Yep.
That all happened freaking last night.
Dude, it was raining like crazy.
They freaking poured all that freaking water right down. Like,
have you been to Lake Charles, Louisiana before to Davila Trucks? I'm not sure.
Lake Charles, is that a really prominent area, or is that, that's really close to freaking New Orleans, ain't it?
Yeah, it should be.
It's like the suburbs of New Orleans? I think so.
For the weight, I want to haul a Rooster. Why don't you put an auxiliary box for deep reduction? Rooster's got an 18-speed in it, and it gets down pretty low. Be classic, baby. Brax's marketplace addiction is crazy.
He's on marketplaces more than, like...
Oh, yeah. It's bad. All right, guys, so we got to get this figured out. We might go to Texas, but we'll probably definitely go to Kentucky. If we don't go to Texas, we'll be in Kentucky next week.
Texas isn't 100% no yet. I was up till about 6 a.m. this morning. I was back up at 9, so, like, I got another, like, probably 4 hours in me tonight. I'll get back busy at it and see if I can get this situated. I don't think the rod's bent. Initially, I did, but,
You think you just need to get it running and let it clear out, or did you already do that?
I think I started up freaking 3 times yesterday to cycle it in, to, like, retighten the intake bolts and the exhaust bolts and stuff, the header bolts and all that, because you don't want to put it in the boost until, like, that stuff, like, the gaskets are fully seated, because you'll knock the gaskets out of it. And then, right now I think the push rods are grinding up on the guide plates.
So you think that's why it made that?
Of course, I went through this whole setup before, but for the people that don't know, it ripped the intake stud out of the head last weekend. Yeah, last weekend? Yeah, whatever.
Yeah, it was weekend before last. You went to Crossville.
Well, I made a 1,700-mile road trip last few days. Got all the parts to fix the heads, put steel inserts in all the intakes, just because the rocker stud goes into the intake port on a big block Chevy. So the threads aren't fully shrouded. There's there's some exposed threads in, like, they're not overly strong. So I put steel inserts in them, and they all torqued up well and everything like that. But when you do that, everything shifts a little bit, and I think I might have missed. I marked everything when I took it off, but, like, on my behalf, not on my behalf, my own screw-up, I think the guide plates might have shifted a little bit, because ideally I need a shaft mount rocker system, and then everything's just, it is what it is. But with the guide plates, they can move around, and if they move around, like, 10 thousandths of an inch, that guide plate, so you can see right here, right? Like, where's it going? This one's at, this one's on the base circle of the cam. You can see how the push rod's, like, already touching right there?
Yeah.
Usually, when you put the rocker on, right, that lifts up, you know, 10-15 thousandths of an inch, and puts your air gap on the back side of here. So when this is torqued down and everything's tight, I think the, you can see, like, kind of like here, you can see right here, the witness mark on it.
Yeah.
So it looks like the push rods are binding up on the guide plates. So I either need to, these guide plates are slotted a little bit. If I can't move this farther, any farther down, well, then I need to go through here with, take all this apart, and get like a Dremel tool or something like that, and you know, open them up 20 thousandths or so, because the guide plates keep the push rod going from, you know, left to right, forward and backward. Well, that changes with the fulcrum of the pivot point of the rocker, but the left or right is what the guide plate's mostly for. But if it does touch on the bottom side as it's going through the valve motion and stuff like that, because you're going to have a little bit of deflection in the push rod and stuff like that, if it touches, it's going to get tight. So I think that's the issue that we're having right now. I'm pretty sure it is. I got to give a shout out to Maddie, because I called my girlfriend, and she's like, Nick, you just changed those. Check the rockers again. But, like, I've taught her a lot in the 7 years we've been together, so...
No, she is pretty good at this stuff.
It's good to have that
support.
Mouse in your back pocket, yeah, or whatever, to bounce ideas off of. I called her up to, you know, FaceTime MVP and tell her good night. I told her a problem, and she's like, well, before I cancel the flight, like, go and check this stuff. And I was like, okay. So I think that might be the issue. We might be back in business here in the next hour or two. Luckily, we're back here. I can start the thing up, and not going to make too much noise to friggin' wake anyone up, but...
You ain't gonna hurt nobody's feelings around here. Everybody around here loves hearing this stuff. But all right, guys, we're gonna go check out one more truck, make sure it's good to go in the morning, and I guess I'm gonna help Nick.
Go get it done, Braxton. Get to work.
Oh, it sucks for you, buddy. And guys, it's race cars are amazing until they're not. Until you got to work on them. And it seems like all the time you gotta work on these dang things. But it's a cool life to live, just for that few minutes of adrenaline. Braxton's trucks is, one's there, there's one back there, and then, let's see, I don't know where the other one is. Running ain't the problem. So the car run, it's just, when he started it's making some weird compression noises, like it's binding up. So, and it leaked water in the exhaust today when it was raining. Well, it rained all night last night and then today, so I thought he got some water in it. Let's check this thing, make sure it's still good to rip another round. We got a real important new load that we're starting to pick up this week that I really need the guys on. And so, guys, I do like the new place. I love the new place, but we're getting ready to stuff this thing full. You guys are going to see a big old huge change coming to Gentry and Sons starting next week, or probably 2 weeks, 3 weeks, end of the month. Yeah, the neighbors like us. So we got good tires, reefer's running good. Let's check this thing, make sure. The data logger ain't working for some reason. Let's see. I bet you that's what the code is. Yep, discharge air sensor. Alternate control sensor. So let's see if we can clear those. So I'm going to put that discharge control sensor. I don't know what's up. It might just have moisture in it, but it's still going to cool. It should be all right. We got, for some reason, the APU's acted up on this thing a little bit. So we got to fix that. And then, what else do we have to do to this tonight? Yeah, you can come visit, brother.
AC.
Oh, yeah, fix the AC, and that might just be quick fixes we could do right here instead of pulling it in. Let's pop the hood. We're already out here. What's wrong with the APU? Right there, I already see it. Where's that wire at? So that wire to the APU is hooked up to the wrong. We gotta rehook it. It's hooked to the wrong lug. So we'll fix that, and the AC is plugged up. Wonder why it ain't working. But I don't see any oil leaks. Our tension is still good. Oil's good in it. Yep, looks good to me, Rex. Alright, so switch the wire on the alternator and what's that noise?
Air Force truck.
Oh, you got the Air Force truck on it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be the pressure switch. We just had all this apart, though, doing the bull gear. Or not the bull gear, but the front cover. So I was just thinking maybe it was a wire or something. Yeah, that probably blew off. Yeah, I'm going to check the fuses and check the all that good stuff. Guys, we are almost at 120 minutes on our live. We're at over 1,000 likes. Me and Brax is going to finish off there. We got to go torque these wheels down and then check this thing out, see if we can't get it fixed. What else are we doing? We got to edit a video. That's what we got to do. He's got to edit us a video. And I'd like to change that discharge sensor, but we got to open the trailer. I don't want to break a seal. I don't like the yellow light being on. Because if it's always on and driver sees yellow, he don't know if it's units messed up or I kicked off. I mean, Dewey's smart and he keeps check on everything, but. I hope you guys enjoyed the live, and we'll definitely do it again here soon. I'll have you guys a video out tomorrow, hopefully. So, Dad is on his way to deliver the yacht, guys. So, I was going to go and get a video from my side and deliver it myself, but... I just got a lot going on right now, a lot, especially business related, and you guys will see soon enough what's going on. It's a lot. It is a lot to take on right now. So things in trucking right now, things are tough, so you got to do what you got to do to survive, and that's what we're doing. You guys, I love y'all, and we'll see you on the next live, or the next video, I guess. It'll be a video.